morning. And welcome to New Thought Unity on this lovely Sunday morning, wherever you are in the universe, in the sanctuary or on the web. We are grateful for this lovely day.
Distance, the world looks blue and green, and the snow-capped mountains white. From a distance, the ocean meets the streams, and the eagle takes to flight. From a distance, the voice of every man.
From a distance, we all have enough, and no one is in need. There are no guns, no bombs, and no disease.
Lovely sun, thank you. It is a lovely Sunday morning in Cincinnati, Ohio, here at New Thought Unity Center. In case you're not in the sanctuary and wondering who you're looking at, we are very grateful that all of you are here. We have a special guest with us this morning, the Reverend Susan EngPoole is our special speaker this morning. Susan graduated from the Unity Institute in 1986. She directed expansion and conference department at Unity Worldwide Ministries. She and her late husband, Jack Poole, served as co-ministers of Unity of Evanston, Illinois for 7 years. She served as senior minister of Unity of Louisville, Kentucky for 12 years and was acknowledged from the Louisville magazine, LEO Weekly, as the Reader's Choice Award's Best House of Worship. And it was wonderful. Yes. Susan was presented the prestigious Myrtle Fillmore Award in 2014. Now in retirement, Susan currently is Unity of Louisville's Minister Emeritus, volunteers on committees for Unity Worldwide Ministries, and serves on the board of the North American Interfaith Network. Welcome.
Welcome.
What an honor and privilege to be here with you in this sacred space with all you wonderful, wonderful souls. It's just an honor to be back. And I want to begin with our affirmation. I am free, I am unlimited. Let's affirm that together.
I am free, I am unlimited.
Let's say it two more times and just really, really get that deep, deep.
I am free, I am unlimited.
I am free, I am unlimited. And now our opening prayer, the words, the invocation from Charles Fillmore, Unity's co-founder. I am now in the presence of pure being and immersed in the Holy Spirit of life, love, and wisdom. I acknowledge thy presence and thy power, O blessed Spirit. In thy divine wisdom, now erase my mortal limitations, and from thy pure substance of love, bring into manifestation my world according to thy perfect law. Amen.
Amen. Now would you please stand and join us in singing, I am free and I am unlimited.
I am free, I am unlimited.
You can turn around and wave. If you're send
Namaste.
Love to each other.
Good morning.
Good morning.
If you're online, please send us a note. Tell us where you're calling from. If you're in your pajamas, that's okay. You can tell us or not. It's wonderful to have you all here this morning. Sort of the intro into our mission and vision statement. If you would say the mission and vision statement with me, that would be lovely. Our mission statement is, in God, we are an inclusive, abundant community, experiencing love, transforming lives, and serving others. And our vision statement, we celebrate a world of harmony and oneness. A place of loving stewardship, sacred connections, and pure joy, where all are welcomed with honor and respect. And what we would like you to know about us is that wherever you are on your spiritual journey, wherever you have been, whatever path you've walked, whatever path you're walking now, you are welcome here, and we're grateful for your presence this morning. This is your first time here. There is in the back corner a newcomer's table, and there are packets of information about Unity, and there's also a gift. We encourage you to go back there and get one, and one of our board members will be back there to, Kim, will be back there to answer any questions you may have about the center. And again, we're grateful for your presence here today. We have a few announcements. Okay. For starters, we have a new members class coming up. Anyone wishing to become a member of NTUC can take the new member class, there's two of them, starting on Saturday, September the 25th, and October the 2nd. From 9 a.m. till noon, both Saturdays. The classes are taught by Regina Steimley and are on a love offering basis. To register, call the center at 513-961-2527 or email administration@ntunity.org or see the email blast or Facebook event for the pre-registration link.
Also, Women of Wisdom, our speaker for this coming Saturday is Allison Frazier, and she will be speaking on Unleash Your Brave, an inspiring workshop to help you get unstuck from fearful life challenges. Okay, join Allison on the WOW this coming Saturday, September the 18th on Zoom. You can call the center for see the email blast or Facebook event page for pre-registration.
Crossport. These are support meetings, and they're held every second and fourth Monday of the month in Friendship Hall and on Zoom at 7:30 p.m. Crossport is a community supporting transgender, gender nonconforming, CDs, and all allies. Questions or inquiries can be made to Lauren Watson or call the center at 513-961-2527.
2527.
Oneness meditation and spiritual blessing is held here at New Thought Unity Center twice a month on the first and third Wednesday of the month. So Ryan Lucan will facilitate this meditation and blessing in Classroom B at 7 o'clock on the first and third Wednesday of the month.
And Angel Wings, all clothing and shoes are $1 per item or $5 per bag. And today is the last day. So, normally they're open, well, every week. They're open from Friday from 10 to 2, Saturday 10 to 4, and today noon to 3. It's your last chance to get these bargains.
Also at Angel's Wings, they have Halloween displays, so get ready for the ghosts and goblins.
And they're moving fast.
Yes, they are. Galleria of Grace gift shop. Are we open today? Well, we're not sure. Galleria of Grace. We are? Okay, Grace gift shop will be open today and Sunday. Today after service for large selections of unique items, and the daily word is also available to purchase. So after you leave here, you go out the door, turn to the right, and they're down the hall on your left. And that is our announcements today. Have we left out anything? I know what I forgot. Are there any birthdays for the month of September or anniversaries? Would you please stand so we can recognize you? God is blessing you now. Okay. Can you join me, please?
God is blessing you now. God is blessing you now. God is blessing you. You are wonderful. God is blessing you now.
Happy birthday or happy anniversary. Now it's that time in our service where we prepare for meditation. So if you will sit back, relax, we will prepare for meditation.
Road is long.
Come to our time of prayer and meditation. I invite you to close your eyes if you feel comfortable. Take in a deep breath through your nose and slowly let it out through your mouth. Two more. In through your nose and out through your mouth. Deep breath. Relax. ain't heavy. He's my brother. That song touched me. I didn't know that was going to be sung, and it just touched me knowing how Reverend Jack Barker, thinking about how all he embodied was love and care. And that's what he would have taught. He ain't heavy. He's my brother. His whole life's purpose, extending, serving, the love and peace that he is. And I invite us to take a moment right now to say thank you to Reverend Jack Barker, to Reverend Pat, and all of our teachers, our loved ones. Say thank you. We know that we are free, we are unlimited, and these words resonate on a universal level because they express an important truth in simple words, a proclamation of our spiritual freedom. I am free. I am unlimited beyond any barriers, any veil. I am free. I'm eternal life. I'm eternal love. I am free. I am unlimited. And I may encounter daily challenges with my work, my relationships, finances, or any number of other elements of this human experience. And so my ego may immediately believe me to be trapped or forced into painful choices shaped by the demands of others. And I take a moment to remember, I am infinite potential. I am always free. I am always unlimited. And I can hear my true self gently singing me that truth. I am free. I am unlimited. There are no ties that bind me. And let's take that into the silence. I am free. I am unlimited. There are no chains that bind me. I am free to exercise my spiritual potential through whatever is occurring in my life. God is free, unlimited, and unbound, and so am I. Thank you, God, for the love light shining through me to experience happiness, wisdom, well-being, prosperity, freedom, life, peace, joy. Knowing that, we know that our brothers, he ain't heavy. He's my brother. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
And I know what makes me tick. And when I need to get my way, I know how to put on thick cream and sugar in my coffee. Right away when I awake, I face the day and pray to God I won't make the same mistakes. No. The pain is self-inflicted. I know it's not good for my health, but it's easier to please the world than it is to please myself. All the rest is out of my hands. I will learn to let go what I cannot change. I will learn to forgive what I cannot change. I will learn to love what I cannot change. And I will change. And I will change whatever I, whenever I can. Change. will change whatever whenever I can. Whatever I can. Whenever I can.
Thank you so much. First class music here always, right? Wow. Thank you. When I heard about Reverend Jack Barker, it was announced last Sunday, I was like, what I cannot change, I wish I could change that. It was like, oh, his passing brought so many wonderful memories, because in 1984, I went to seminary at Unity Institute, and Reverend Jack Barker was already there, and he had already served sterling leadership as the president of the Board of Trustees. He'd served that 1982. So he was one of the many or few revered ministers, and he was, you know, I like Chinese astrology things, and I said, oh, he was born the year of the goat, you know, greatest of all time. He was definitely one of the greatest of all time. And serving the Unity, it was called the Association of Unity Churches, and now it's called Worldwide Ministries. It's interesting to me to watch the history and watch how history repeats itself. So, Reverend Jack was president of the Board of Trustees, and then Reverend Pat Barker served as president of the Board of Trustees. And then just watching who the ministers are, I mean, he served this church for 30 years. He was just like so honored and revered. He's amazing, amazing man. And so then I watched Reverend Pat Williamson, because he followed my husband, Reverend Jack Poole, at Unity in Evanston, Illinois. And Reverend Pat became the president of the Board of Trustees for Unity Worldwide Ministries. And Reverend Doris Hoskins was first chair. And so here is Reverend Jack Barker just being this legacy of love and light and leadership. And by the way, this message today, it was kind of like already given the dates, because it's the 20th anniversary of 9/11, and today is Grandparents' Day. So really, Reverend Jack Barker, Reverend Pat, our grandparents, really giving us their legacy of their wisdom, their love, and their light. And just watching as models what they do, because I want to be more like them, and so elegant and so wise and excellent leadership. And 2001, who would be the recipient of the Charles Fillmore Award, but Reverend Jack and Pat Barker. And watching that, Reverend Pat Williamson became the recipient of the Charles Fillmore Award. And I know that it was taught so many times here, who you are the Christ. You are the way showers, the healers, the teachers, the light workers, the ascension workers. You're it. And he was called for 30 years to serve here. And now he's called to lead from across the veil. And it's time for us to step up. It was Reverend David Florence gave me these words I loved, because he said he uses these words every day, and they were written for the Unity Worldwide Ministries directory. And this was published in 1995 in that directory. So he uses it every day, and I thought, oh, this is so beautiful. I'm going to use it every day too. Beloved Christ of my being, I pray to live so much in the awareness of your presence that everything I do will be a blessing to those around me. My heart overflows with gratitude for your grace, which ameliorates my mistakes. For as long as I love, I will be freed by your love and filled with your joy. I dedicate myself, my life, this day to my Christ, my beloved. Well done, good and faithful servant. He was extending that prayer for all of us. Reverend Jack Barker, well done, good and faithful servant. Thank you. There's so much going on in the world right now. There's so many systems that are falling, that need to fall. Our political system, just not working, educational, financial systems, school systems, health systems, they all need to fall. And we're feeling the energy of that right now, and we're in this awakening process to be awake to it, of how many lies and deceit and just trying to control us there's been over thousands of years, if we look at it. And now we're waking up to it, and it's an exciting time to be alive, to be in this energy, to be the light workers, the star seeds. You've been hearing this message, and now it's you're taking the mantle to, you're the legacies to carry it forward, to extend that light. And so thank God you're the ones to help the others in this energy of awakening. And we're in that energy right now. Sometimes it feels like it's like, what is going on? We've got lots of energy. We don't have any energy. We're losing things, or our loved ones, or just painful experiences that we have to face up to and feel right now in order to awakening, in order to ascend into this new heaven on earth. Heaven on earth, new earth, the apocalypse, the end. And it's not scary. It's exciting. So we hear on the news all these scary things. And yet we see in the Bible 365 times in the Bible, do not fear, do not fear. Because if we hold that kind of energy in our bodies, it will affect us some way in our world. Do not fear. And so that's what we're guided to do. And so many times from this pulpit, in this ministry, you've learned thoughts are things. Like begets like. Whatever we hold in our minds, expresses in our world. To really, it's important for us to really get that now. What are we holding in our minds? If it's fear, let it go. If it's painful experiences, experience it. Instead of stuffing it so it won't go out sideways, experience the sadnesses and the anger, and then let it go. We're in a time now where we are in this heaven on earth, new heaven on earth, but sometimes it doesn't feel like it. Sometimes we've seen where people are in exactly the same situations, and one's having a terrible experience and the other one's in just bliss. It's because we've trained our minds, right, to be happy, to be in gratitude for whatever's going on in our world, and just know that it's good, no matter what it feels like, no matter what it looks like. And what about the fake news? It's like, what do you believe? What don't you believe? I invite us to really look at what we believe. What do I really believe? And not watch the fake news that much anymore, because you know what? It's all fake news. It's all designed to manipulate and control. We've been taught that we have our own inner wisdom to ask our inner Christ when we have a question, because we know. I'm in the study group, and every Friday night we get together, and so we got into a discussion because we watched a video about the vaccine and what it does. And some of us in the group have been vaccinated and some haven't. And some are seeing this information for the first time. And what happens, it's like we want to open our minds to everything to discover the truth and not be so close-minded in what we think we believe and think that it's true. And so what happened was this, like, it could have been heated. It was heated for us, but not really, because it's a spiritual group. But when you hear any information for the first time that doesn't resonate or doesn't, it just shakes up your comfort zone, because you've had this solid belief for so long, and then you hear something else, and it just, it'll make you angry, agitated. And so that energy is going on in our world right now, and just don't get into that. But that discussion was a good example of how, okay, we're spiritual beings, we're brothers, we can talk about this. But the bottom line was, it really didn't matter about who's vaccinated and who's not vaccinated, because it's like the important thing is, what are we doing to bring unity in the world, love into the world, healing? What are we doing that may be creating a gap or a divide because we have our opinions? But really look deep on those opinions and see that, you know, it may or may not be true. But anything in this physical world is not true. It's only true if it's non-physical love, life, peace, joy, wisdom. That's all that's true. And to remember that in this chaos, everything's got to come up. It's got to come up to be healed. And Unity called it the New Jerusalem, that we're entering our new earth, our New Jerusalem. But in the meantime, in this process, we are the ones. We are the ministers. We are the teachers and the light workers to extend the love and the light. My brother died of COVID, and we did his memorial service just two Saturdays. It's been two Saturdays. And I was studying. I've been doing genealogy anyway, and I'm thinking, oh, Don, my brother Don, his middle name is Key. I knew it, you know. His initials were K, but K-E-E, so looking at the family history, I'm going, oh, we've never used that. We should be so proud. I mean, the recent Rose Bowl parade, there was a big old portrait of on the railroad float of the one picture of the portrait. Oh, my goodness, that's my family. That's my great-grandfather. with his work in the railroad, but he never used that name. Then I thought, oh, Don, and his middle name's Key. Donkey. All these years we missed a great opportunity to tease him about his name, and we never did. And then I remembered, wait, do you remember Jesus rode a donkey, a colt? This unruly colt into Jerusalem, into the New Jerusalem. And the culture then was the kings chose to ride a horse if you want war, if you choose war, into Jerusalem. And you rode a humble colt that you couldn't control, you know. As a leader, you're extending peace when you ride a donkey. And I remembered that. But we are each entering the New Jerusalem now. And as Jesus was riding that colt, that donkey, into New Jerusalem, he was so certain, so clear about what he was doing. He knew what was ahead for him. He knew that. But that was his triumphal entry. So we're at a time right now, each one of us riding that colt, that donkey, into the New Jerusalem. And to be really, we need to be really, really clear about, what do I want? That's the question. What do I want? And to be in certainty of that. What do I want? I want to be one with God, with good, with truth, with love, with life, with wisdom. To be only in certainty of that, and to discard any other distractions except to ride that donkey into this New Jerusalem, to have that be the focus. There's so many distractions, so many. You know, it's breaking news, breaking news, breaking news. It's designed to break our peace. This morning, as a gift for each one of you, I brought anise star seeds to remind you of who you are as a star seed. And what I'd love for you to do with it is just to hang on to it and to remind you about self-care, to take care of yourself, to care for it. And eventually it's going to crumble, but you know what? It's okay, because it makes us really healthy beneficial for you. Tea, you know, fights flu, fights colds, it smells good. So that's your gift. And also, in a memorial service, and I wanted to particularly pay tribute to Reverend Jack Barker today, but in a memorial service, you receive, in the Chinese style, you receive a white envelope, and in that white envelope is a dime or a coin, but usually, you know, like the dime is closest to the number 9, which means infinity. Or here, the 8 is infinity. And then there's a piece of candy in there to remind you that life is always sweet. And in a white envelope, this is a Chinese funeral color, but there's the Chinese word for peace, and it looks like a rice, a grain of rice, and a sign. And here in this culture, we want a sign from our loved ones. We want a sign from our loved ones that they're okay. We got to know, though, that they are okay. They've been called to serve from across the veil. But we've got it backwards here. They want a sign from us. That's what that word means. They want a sign from us that we're okay. And so what we want to do in our gratitude to Reverend Jack Barker is to show Reverend Jack Barker who we are as his legacy of love, of light. And to live our life fully expressing traits, good traits. What a good man. We all have wonderful, wonderful memories. Maybe not all of us, but he's touched so many lives. So that's our assignment, to go forth into our world, to express a legacy of love, light, peace, and joy. God bless you.
Feel free to sing along, all right?
Yes, you can even stand up and move if you feel it.
Everything I've lost or won, everything I've ever
It's that time in our service where we take our tithes and offering in our hands. And if you're giving online or using the machine in the back, please say our offertory blessing with us. And you can push the button on the button as after we say our blessing and just know that it has been received. And if you're doing snail mail, as always, remember to put a stamp on the envelope. And our offertory blessing is this. Divine love, moving in and through me, blesses and multiplies all that I give and all that I receive. And let's just take that offertory blessing inside for a moment and feel those words that we have just spoken. And so it is. Know that our on-duty chaplains for today are Lauren and Linda and Sandy, and they will all be over here at the prayer shawl to pray with you, a celebratory prayer, or any prayer request that you may have. Know that you are never alone, and they are always here to pray with you before service and after service as they hold sacred space during service. Alice, you gonna do that?
We have just a few notes from the internet. First of all, happy birthday to Brenda.
Yay.
And welcome back, Susan.
Yay.
Reverend Susan, they're grateful that you're back. Grateful for your presence and your message. Colleen Marie is watching from Louisville.
Or Louisville, as they say.
Marilyn Baker and others send their love.
So we thank you all for truly, truly being here today. And we're waiting our ushers to bring down the basket so Miss Reverend Susan EngPoole can bless it. We hope you have a wonderful day today. And for those of you that might be going to the Bengals game, that you enjoy the game.
Abundance, joy, and peace. Get ready, my soul. We are now in heaven on earth. Get ready, my soul, to receive God's abundance. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Thank you, God. Amen. 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 And now, if you'll please stand up and join us as we do our prayer for protection and sing our closing song. You can stand where you are and make eye contact with one another. And our prayer for protection is, the light of God surrounds me, the love of God enfolds me, the power of God protects me, the presence of God watches over me. Wherever I am, God is, and all is well.
With God.
line. Get ready.